Hello everyone, I am Mansi Sharma, Senior Correspondent with Exchange for Media, and I welcome you all once again to another panel in our Cannes series. As we touched upon during the last discussion, that winning a Cannes Lions, being an Indian participant, is not an easy task at all. Some of the times you have to deal with a lot of Western bias, then there are cultural hesitations in putting your point across to the jury. But still, there have been so many cases that Indian contingent has picked so many lions for us. And today we have some of the most profound guests with us who have picked the lions. Some of them have also been a part of the jury in the past. And today they'll be talking about their crowning moments, their winning glories, and how did they do it? Let's start with introducing the panel. First of all, we have Kainaz and Harshad, the chief creative officers at Ogilvy India, which is arguably one of the most successful agencies at Cannes. Their best stint has been picking nine lions together in 2017. And for me personally, some of their most amazing works have been with Make Love Not Scars. Next in, we have Josie Pohl, the chairman and chief creative officer at BBDO India, who has been on a consistent winning spree. And three of his agency's campaigns were named in Lion's Creativity Report of the Decade last year as well, including the much celebrated Share the Load, which is in the running this year as well. Then we have Ramanuj Shastri, the director at CCO Infectious Advertising, who too, with his extensive career spreading across agencies like Ogilvy, McCann, and Publicis, has held several Lions in his hands. Then he has also been a part of the Cannes jury in the past. Then we have Santosh Padhi, the co-founder and CCO of Taproot Dentsu, who is also quite habitual of picking the lions. Almost every year he has one new on his shelves to boast of. Next, we have Rajdeepak Das, the CEO and CCO at Leo Burnett South Asia. Among his other laurels, his work for Whisper Touch the Pickle had won the inaugural Cannes Lions Grand Prix for India. And it was a great campaign that broke the menstruation taboo in India. And then we have Senthil Kumar, the chief creative officer at Wunderman Thompson India. He also got India's first golden film and film craft Lions years ago. And since then, his winning spree hasn't stopped. I welcome all of you and thank you so much for giving your time to the panel today.
Thanks, Mansi.
We'll start the discussion. First of all, one by one, by knowing which has been your favorite winning moment or your favorite campaign that has picked a lion. We'll start with Josie because he is first on my screen.
Okay. Thank you, guys. Is that okay if I go first? Please.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So, you know what? We got a shock of our lives in 2015 when I was in Delhi Ajay and I were staying together, and I get a call at the middle of the night saying that we won both the Grand Prix and the gold. I mean, it was unbelievable. And then they even said they would send us a private jet to get us to Cannes. And it was like, what's happening? And I remember Ajay is such a peaceful, quiet guy, but even he was screaming like a madman. And then... this was for the campaign Share the Load and Touch the Pickle, which I worked with Raj. And then, of course, we never got... My passport was not... had expired. So I lost all chance of going to Cannes. So we watched it from the office and it was great to be together as a team. But that entire 2 days of magic where I couldn't tell anyone that we had won it because it was a secret... So holding a secret for that long, man, that's what I remember most, holding on to that secret till the news was announced. So for me, that was a beautiful thing. Also because it was the inaugural Glass Lion. It was something very close to my heart. It was something that I believed in. And the work we had done that year for both Touch the Pickle and Share the Load to gain recognition was unbelievable. I still can't believe it.
Oops. Okay. For me, it'll always be the first film and film craft gold lines for India that we won, Nakamuka, A Day in the Life of Chennai. I think that was the most defining moment, not just at Cannes for me, but in my career as well. And I think it sort of gave me one platform and confidence in film, which I've tried to sort of build on, and every year try something different in film, try something unique, try something Indian, and gave me all that hope. And it was fantastic to hear a Tamil song play on the Cannes stage, and you know, everybody applaud, you know, Tamil being my mother tongue, and you know, it's usually Hindi out there, right? When we send a piece other than English, I mean, it's largely less of the language work gets to an international festival. So I think that was the most defining moment. And there's a famous Tamil song by Rajini. All of you know Rajini Khan, in this movie called Murattu Kalai. It was one of his most defining films. And the two lines of the film, I mean, the song is Poduvaga en manasu thangum, potin vandu vitta singum, which is basically means, usually my heart is gold, but if there is a competition on, then it becomes a lion, right?
Very fitting.
I think that was I started ringing in my head, and it's still ringing, I guess. And it was fantastic. I don't think I've ever beaten that. Over to the others. Thank you.
You said that there's seldom any work in Indian regional languages that make it to the Cannes, but I feel that with the quality and the quantity of work that we are generating in the direction right now from the past few years, I think we are going to see many more of them in the coming years, hopefully. Next, Kainaz, why don't you tell us what has been your favorite moment at Cannes?
Yeah, I will. So, I mean, for me, it's very clear. We did win a Grand Prix, so that will always remain really special. But for me, even more special was the Glass Lion Gold, because that was the first time that I walked on the stage of Cannes. And I don't think I'll ever forget that moment. And we didn't know anything when we won. Like, we were told that you got a mail from Cannes saying you won a gold and two people can go on stage. And we were all sweating, saying two people, but we are four people team. Who will go on stage? This one will go and that one will go. And then Piyush said, nahi nahi, ek kaam karo, sabka naam de do. And we didn't know then that everyone would be allowed, you know, because we were so new to the whole thing. So we gave everybody's name and we reached there early so that in case we have to fight to go in. And they just ticked off our names and then let us in. So we were like super thrilled to sit there. So that was most memorable for me. Also, I want to say Josie was on that jury. So thank you, Josie.
Thank you, Enas.
Santosh.
I think... me being a passionate art director craft guy, I'd pick up the Times of India Farmer Suicide Campaign. Mm-hmm. Many stories around it. It picked up 4 gold that year across categories. So, an interesting story. I walked on the stage to pick up the outdoor lions. It had picked up 2 outdoor golds, one for media publication, one for craft. And unfortunately, I missed out the announcement that they will be clubbing both the awards together. One will be given and one you have to collect backstage. So I was like completely gearing up to go on the stage. So when I walked on the stage, Tony Gruninger, who was the jury president, he just handed over one lion to me. So it's a Cannes gold lion winning moment. And I am a little upset because I'm searching where is the second gold in his hand. I'm looking at that girl who usually brings the Cannes gold on the plate. I'm looking at her. She's not coming back. So I was like little saying, ki, bhai, ho kya raha hai, mera 2 gold hai. I mean, everywhere it's announced as 2 gold, why they're giving 1 gold to me? So I just came little upset, little grumpy, because this lions are like toy for all creative guys. So I said, mera to yaar, ek khilona ghum gaya yaar, ek mil nahi raha hai, ki thama ke bhej diya mujhe. So I came, then somebody told me later on saying, ki, the second one you have to go and pick it up from the backstage once the award season is over. So I think that's one interesting snippet that stayed. It'll stay forever in my head.
All's well that ends well.
Yeah,
Harshal?
Besides the year of Biklav Notskas that Kenas touched upon, I would like to recount the next year after that, immediately after 2016, the 2017 Lions, which was by far richest hole where, as you mentioned, we came back. We came back with 9 lands would be a bit incorrect. We were here in Bombay only because that was the one of the years when we really couldn't send anybody, including ourselves, to Cannes. Of course, various reasons, budgeting, so on and so forth. And I think there is some sort of like a, you know, there's some divine justice to it, quite like Josie's story when he was in Bombay and those wonderful news blasts were coming in from there. Similarly, in our case, we were probably the only, we were winning really big that time. We had no clue we would win like that big. We were all loving that piece because it had already picked up DNADs, one shows and so on and so forth. But we were all here. The first day was a Sunday and we started getting messages from everybody that we knew and seeing that it's one in health. Next day, it's one in design. Third day, it was, and by far, like we picked up multiple golds, multiple silvers, multiple bronzes, and we were all here, either in Vakola in Bombay or Bandra or Malad or wherever. And everybody from our fraternity was saying, where the hell are you guys? Yola ruling the show and nobody's here. But luckily, due to my friend Paddy over here, I at least have pictures of that place from the auditorium. Paddy would diligently click every time we won and WhatsApp it to me from Cannes. And again, Salah, tum log hai kidhar? You all should have been here. But nonetheless, I mean, we are glad at least like Piyush was there and he could pick up the 2 goals on stage. That would be my memorable year.
Ramanuj?
Hi, my memorable year would be the goal that we picked up for Thanda Matlab Kokala print. And it was more a validation of the fact that, you know, a campaign which was not necessarily got the okay of the big boys and which was supposed to be a small regional, you know, sideshow, which suddenly becomes such a big, big thing. And the pictures were from like, you know, a barber shop and there was a guy with those push things that you, you know, wet your hair with. And it just went Thanda Matlab Kokala and I realized that cultural context is such an important thing, you know, and they get the joke and everybody gets the humor, everybody gets the subtlety, you know, and in fact, it's fresh because it's so different because nobody, as a people, we repurpose things and, you know, and Coca-Cola bottles still remain cool even after long after the Coca-Cola is over. And I think they got that and it was delightful that, you know, the jury from all over the world got that joke and it was fun.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
Raj Deepak?
Yeah, I think mine was not winning one. So I'll tell you why. I remember the year we had, I think that is exactly 4 years back, we had Bajaj V going into Cannes. And the best is every Indian guy says, dude, it's going to win big. And the end of the award show, you had one bronze. Because everyone killed it saying it's a war story and a war is not good and everything. Because see, it's a war is... We have not fought a war. Yeah, we defended our country. But for the world, it was a war story. But the fun was not that. You got a bronze. You are so angry because you didn't win anything. I start walking. Unlike Paddy, I don't know how to walk like that or run and everything. I start walking in the Cannes. And once I had a walk, then I walked 15 kilometers. Ab wapas kaise aayega? So I came back. I remember I ended up back in Cannes by night, 2 o'clock, because I walked one side 15 and walked back one side 15. Still, like, you know, everyone like, dude, you're missing and everything. I left my phone. I says, no, I just walked because I was so angry that we didn't win. For a brand that you felt that it's so important for the nation, you build a brand and few marketing campaign build brands. And this is the first time marketing campaign build a brand, Bajaj V. Till next year, you win the Black Lion gold. Effectiveness gold. How Josie said, na wo bichara kya hota na, kabhi kabhi ek campaign ko na, 3 baar agni pariksha mein jana padta hai. एक बार क्रिएटिविटी में एक बार एफेक्टिविटी में बात करके केपीएमजी जाता है वो अच्छे से देन वो ब्लैक हो जाता है यू नो बट द जॉय वाज नॉट विनिंग द जॉय वाज नॉट विनिंग बट यू थॉट इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर इंडिया बट द वर्ल्ड डोंट गिव अ डैम अबाउट योर वर्क एंड आई थिंक दैट्स द ब्यूटी ऑफ इट आई थिंक विनिंग तो या वी हैड इट नेक्स्ट ईयर बट the not winning, the anger, the sadness, I think that makes you feel more alive for that. I think that's more memorable for me.
Okay, that's interesting. Before I go on to my next question, there's an interesting question from Avril Jain in the audience. He's saying that it is commonly said that to win an international award, India tends to indulge in a bit of poverty porn. What are your comments? Anyone who would like to take that?
So can you repeat again? Hurry.
So he's saying that to win an international award, India tends to indulge in a bit of poverty porn, sort of like showing the poor or like the negative side of India more. Some sad stories.
So anyone
they have a better chance of winning.
Josie, can you talk about it?
Poverty porn. I don't know. I can only speak about what we've done, right? I mean, I don't know. I don't know if that is.
I will somehow agree and disagree in two ways, and tell you why I disagree with that. Because either it is Kanal's work on the Savlon that I'm a big fan of. It is, or it's a job, Touch the Pickle that we did in what do you call that? I think Josie and we worked on India, but like in BBDO. Or we did when we did a lot of the Dastan in India. See, it says we are actually telling the human solution. All the idea come to solve Indian problem. And when you saw this problem and beautiful people, it's not a poverty. It's the solution of that area, and they're getting a solution for that. So when you see it, it's not poverty porn. It's actually showing what the actual problem is. And if you don't show the actual problem is, you don't know what a solution is. If you don't show what is the, if they're writing a chalk, it can solve the solution. It's not a poverty problem. It's actually telling this is the problem and this is the solution for everywhere what you have done. I think if the visual is that, if you look at Bajaj, it was a beautiful visual, or it was like a lot of Paddy's work that we've done in, I think Adidas. It's beautifully shot, right? It's not poverty all the time. It's what we are going to talk about it that time. All the Nike work, I think one of my favorite pieces of work, like every ad count is brilliantly shot and brilliantly done. All those pieces of work also got the beauty of India. I think it's always about what the context is and what you're going to find a solution for that. And that becomes the front of it. Doesn't matter what it is, poverty or it is beauty or it is cricket or it is sports. I think
you
put that in the front.
I agree with him. Also, I feel there is one other thing which people always forget, and they always are very hard on advertising, but not on cinema, which is that every piece that you do will always reflect the culture of the place that you live in, you know? So if you go to see one of the most acclaimed films in the world is Bicycle Thief, does that mean it is peddling poverty? It is not. It is reflecting what is happening in society and writing a beautiful story about it. So many of Satyajit Ray's films are set with a very poor background, but people are not so hard on them. But when it comes to advertising, everybody has to, you know, sort of sit with a highly critical lens and try to find that, you know, almost a forced exploitation angle to every single thing. But I don't believe it is true. And I also feel that, you know, if you are going to solve a problem, then you have to take a problem that exists, right? Like, for example, if water is an issue in India and you make a film reflecting the water issue of India, how is that exploitation? It's taking it and it's reflecting it. And nobody would even think it is exploitation had it not won an award. But when it wins an award, then it automatically gets categorized as, oh, but it was done, you know, for awards, which may well not be the case.
Yeah, I'll just add a bit. I think as a nation, I think what Raj and Kenna say, absolutely bang on. I'll just add to it. I think as a nation, we have too many social issues in our country. And as both these guys said, advertising is there to solve a problem. If the nation has too many problems, we need to address it. Mm-hmm. If you look at 90% of the work that is winning at Cannes and everywhere else, they're all related. Even brands are doing social work these days, are getting a social twist to all the brands, okay, to the services that they are into. Why? Because be it gun violence, be it Black Lives Matters, last 3 years winning big for US. I think they are not being questioned. We are being questioned because our narrative has not been right. For all these years, we have not told the story in a wonderful way. Or maybe they have not cut ice in awards. But the minute it goes and wins, I think that issue gets further solved, because the kind of PR those award-worthy work gets, it automatically reaches the common people via the social media and they get solved. So I think the more social issues we address, it's better for our society. Yeah, how do we do it? It's a challenge. Yeah, we need to have our narrative fixed. We need to tell our story very well. In past many years, we have not done that very well. Maybe that's the reason many guys are sulking, I would say. But I think we need to address and think it's a way of giving back to the society.
I will, Bansi, add a small thing. You know what, Harshad, something happened in my office and I was telling my creative team, you know, find some nice images of India. And one of them I says, ki Harshad ka pictures link kya, wo bahut acha hai. You know, and that shows that it's the beautiful image of India. It's not the poverty of India. It's a beautiful image that you smile at it. I live it every day. It's my life, right? It's when I get out of my house or it's my house, the same image, I see it every day. I think that's the beauty of it. I think it's not poverty. It's what we live in. The world may see it, but it's part of our life.
Exactly. Anyone else?
The music in the background?
That's part of us, that.
Yeah, that's...
It's not my background.
Are you guys hearing it?
Yeah, we can hear.
Okay, I thought something's happening to me.
No, we are all hearing it.
It's in all our heads.
Someone from the audience.
It's all our heads.
I think Raj ke earphone se leak ho raha hai. He is wearing big one.
He's asking multi
listening. Where is it coming from?
Yeah, it is coming from somewhere.
It's coming from somewhere.
I think Kainajan or Paddy maybe.
No, there's nothing.
I'm alone in a quiet room.
2020 and 2021 have permanently elevated.
Oh, somebody is listening to the CAN broadcast.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, is it mine? Let me check. My browser is open. No, it's not mine. No, it's not mine.
Are needed in the world.
I think the CAN live streaming has started on somebody's computer.
Oh, conversation.
Let me check if it's mine.
I did stop.
Sorry, it was me. I realized it.
No problem.
Yeah, I was right, Raj.
Spotify. It was Spotify. On. I didn't realize it.
I thought it was something.
Well, moving on. About this cultural context, we had a discussion in our last panel too, where we were discussing how to present.
Mansi, your voice.
My voice is again gone?
Yeah.
Got better. Now it's
better.
Okay. So we were discussing it in the last panel as well, wherein we were chatting about how to present your entries to Cannes, or how do you pick your entries, which entries to send. There also this discussion about the cultural context, and including stories about poverty or many other social issues that we have in India came up. So do you think while presenting your case to the jury, it actually helps to have certain sort of cultural context to your advertisements? Anyone who would like to take, Josie, why don't you start?
You're talking about case studies that you can share with clarity. Yeah, so I mean, when we did the case study for Touch the Pickle, it was the most complicated thing to share with an international audience, which is so diverse, right? Even within the country, it becomes very sort of confusing because these are such nuanced stories and layered. How do you tell people about this? So one of the things that I did was I after I wrote the basic case study and did a rough one, I shared it with people across the world, friends I knew, and they started telling me, we don't understand anything. So then I tried again. Again, they said, we are not getting it. So it took me at least 4 to 5 different versions before the point about what, say, Raj and I had done could come through to the people across the world. And then finally, our creative council helped us say, maybe if you help people understand these taboos, which nobody's getting, you'll be able to get through. And that's how slowly, layer by layer, we built on it. It's like craft. It takes time and you can't assume what's in your head is going to be in someone else's point of view. So it takes that. And for me, that learning also came partly because of something I did with the work that Paddy and Aggie had done for Mumbai Mirror. Because I think when I deconstructed the film, because we had decided on main stage not to share our work, but to share what we feel was the best work in the country. And so I chose Mumbai Mirror, I Am Mumbai. And that process I went through in interviewing the people who had made it, and then I went and deconstructed it. It showed me that people are willing to understand the nuances. And Raj will tell you about the Japanese guy who was sitting next to him. He almost wanted to commit harakiri because he was so, like, went crazy about what is happening in Mumbai, like, you know, for the film. And so I think there is a way to reach out. There is a way to reach out. And I think our role is to be that ambassador, that bridge, that cultural exchange person. And for me, that experience, both with what Paddy and Aggie had done and the work we did with Touch the Pickle, allowed me to reach out to an audience that may not understand.
Raj, you would like to add something to that?
I think very interesting thing that you asked, like Spikes, we are having a chat with Phil Thomas on this thing. You know, the biggest problem with Asia is when, like you said,
Okay, Raj, you froze.
Connection.
Yeah. While he reconnects, anyone else? Senthil, you would
can,
like
to... Can you hear me? Sorry, can you hear me?
Okay, it's back.
Can you hear me? Sorry, my internet, yeah. Okay, so I think we're having a very interesting chat with Phil Thomas in Spikes on exactly the same thing. India, Asia used to win 18% of metals. And now that 5 years has gone to 10% of metals. Now that shows how much decline has happened, except if you take New Zealand and Australia out of it. The reason is how we tell our context to the world. And we're discussing about it because either you see all the country in Asia have very strong culture.
Yeah.
And it's wrong to also say the world don't understand our culture. If you see Cambodia, but at the work from Colombia or Puerto Rico or East Timor, they're telling a story. And the world has been democratized now. Sorry, Cannes has been democratized. There was a time US, UK, Brazil, and Australia, and Japan used to be those five countries used to win medals. But now, East Timor, Pakistan, Vietnam, Cambodia, like you see the kind of stories, the human stories they're coming out of. I think most important thing is the problem is the same. Every country have the problem is the same. But how simplified you tell the problem in the first 15 seconds? You know, it's very important. Like in press, I think Paddy told me a very interesting thing. Raj, like in 2 seconds, you can stop anyone. You know that you've got a shortlist. Remember Paddy and we had a chat with once in a Cannes. He says, the same way, if the contextual problem has been told in the first 5 to 10 seconds and talk about how big is the problem. It's like TED Talk. You talk about the story. You told about the problem in the 15 seconds. Then you have the time to explain the insight and how you're going to solve the problem. It's important. 15 seconds, tell the problem, very important. Everyone can understand it. We are very globalized now. Everyone can understand what we are.
Senthil?
Yeah, I tend to agree because it is a multicultural, multilingual sort of audience out there, right? And the world is a stage. And without context, I mean, your concept might fall by the wayside. But like Raj is also saying, you know, the first 10 seconds, if you can crack the context and move on to what your idea is, I mean, that sort of sets it up nicely. And you really need a powerful context to make your idea more powerful than it is.
Interesting. Ramanuj, you would like to add, I guess you are the most experienced on this panel, or is it Josie?
Hey, I definitely.
So you'll have like how it has transformed. You will have an idea of how it has transformed.
No, so... the thing is that cause is everything, okay? Causes are dominating awards across, like, there was a time when Thai humor used to take 10 medals, you know, every year, you know, 7 medals to Thailand for. You follow the chair for the humor that is there. But more and more, the world is moving towards causes and, you know, people are buying into brands and not just buying them, which means that from tokenism to really doing something, brands are jumping into the bandwagon of causes. In India, as other panelists have pointed out, our causes are very different because they're based on very cultural, you know, we have patriarchy, gender inequality at, you know, unprecedented levels. There is domestic violence. We have much, you know, our house needs to set in order, and we more and more will go with these causes. But we need also to quickly put the context of it. Like, you know, why is this so important? How many people does it affect? What we're trying to do? And, you know, what difference are we trying to get at? But it has to be done quickly, because we are talking to a very impatient group of people. The jury are very smart and they're very good. Don't over-explain, just do enough to whet their appetite and you show them how elegantly you have solved it. And 15 minutes has to be used very, very wisely. And I had never thought of it, but the Josie's idea of sending your case across to all your colleagues everywhere in the world just to do a cross-check, like, you know, does it make any sense to you at all? Or it's just, you know, I'm just talking nonsense here. It would be a fantastic, I've never thought of it, but it's a beautiful way to cross-check whether your explanation is making sense, you know, and that is very important.
Kainaz, would you like to add something?
Yeah, so I think a lot of good points have been made, but I'll just give a small example. Is that when recently we had done a campaign on Dove, which was about arranged marriage. Yeah. And the pressures that women face when it comes to arranged marriage and how the women look. Now, arranged marriage is a very India-Asia kind of a concept. And to explain that itself could take 2 minutes, which is a case video duration that we have. So we came up with a real real shortcut for it. And like Josie said, we send it to our international people and they got it immediately, which is we showed an animal market where animals are bought and sold, and you look at a horse's ears and you look at a cow's rump and you buy it. And we showed that, and this is how Indian girls are looked at before getting married. Yeah. And, you know, when we put it like that and we sent the case study to our international people, they got it in 1 second that, okay, what is arranged marriage? And this is what women are subjected to. Otherwise, it would have taken us 2 minutes to just explain what happens in arranged marriage. But that is the thing we used in case study. So I think we have to be creative and smart and quick about setting the context.
Exactly. Harshal?
I just want to add one more point, which is linked to what Raj very rightly said, the democratization of the biggest of shows, including Cannes. Mm-hmm. Because now actually the role reversal has also happened. And I've seen certain cases where even the West, now they have realized, see, because this thing now about Asia and Indians having to explain and go that extra mile to explain ourselves, our context to the Western jury, now is no longer a given. Now the jury comes from everywhere. And there are dignified names from very professional names from India, from Japan, from Pakistan, from Australia, from Thailand. So the Americans and the Brits also have to try equally hard to set the context. For example, recently I've seen so many cases of what this happened during the last election between Trump and Biden. Now, if the rest of the world is not as deeply involved in what their processes are, so they also have to take those 15 seconds to cut to the gut of things and say that in America, this happens. This is why there is lethargy. This is why people don't go out. So I think now it's I think I agree with what Raj said. I think the democratization has ensured that it might be the Japs, it might be the Brits, it might be the Americans. Everybody now has to kind of, they can't take it for granted that their case will be understood like this. So I think that's a great thing. I think
you are a part of the jury this time. So would you agree to what Harshad is saying?
Yeah, I completely agree with some of the point that has been put up. But I want to say one thing, which is when you do a campaign to talk to your consumers, you talk to them in a very different narrative.
Yeah.
The same narrative can't be put across in front of the international jury.
Mm.
We need to rig it up. We need to put it in certain way, as Josie and many others said. We have to put a context by which they know. So it's an absolutely different narrative. Maybe you have taken 2 minutes, 5 minutes, 5 days, a month to talk to the consumers. But fortunately, unfortunately, you have to talk to the international jury in that 2 minute. A campaign that you have done for good 3 to 6 months. It's unfortunate, but that's how the world is panning. Earlier, it should be 5 minutes for the jury, then jury don't have time. Now it's 2 minutes. God knows, it will be T20. Well, they'll be only giving you 30 seconds, 50 seconds. So I think the lifespan of everything is reducing. So I think most of the time it has to be fake, because the 2 minute video that you do is actually rigged. You shoot it. Unfortunately, the craft now goes into that 2 minute film. it's unfortunate because the real craft is being sidelined, and now the making of this 2 minute becomes the core of everything. So now somebody has to really champion this. If you don't have the capacity or capabilities, you reach out to somebody because you have a fantastic story to tell the world, which may fetch you award. So you have to go to reach out to some people. Some people are fortunate to reach out in a big network, but there are some people who have a good story. And I would like to tell one story about, it's a decade old story. I think Chell has done a beautiful piece of work that actually can have an impact on the society, a positive way. So the whole idea was, I think some of you guys will remember, it's called minus 1 point size. So the entire campaign was done for Samsung set of printers, saying anything that you print, you reduce the point size by one.
Yeah.
And if you print 100 page, I think few pages will be saved. Mm-hmm. I thought it was a fabulous ageless idea, can be implemented any part of the world and really makes the world a better place. Now, when I saw that case study at Goa Fest, I thought this is the most powerful idea I have ever seen coming out from India. So, but pathetic case study, pathetic board. So I couldn't stop myself. I called up the Delhi office when I came back from Goa Fest. And I said, I want to speak to the team who has created this piece of work. Mm-hmm. So the receptionist was like a little hesitant, but she somehow managed and transferred the call to a guy called Vishal Sagar. He was a writer. And I spoke to him and said, dude, congratulations. This is a wonderful piece of work, but you need to change the board and the case study because that's what the jury will be interacting at. Very few people who will look at the big idea and reward, because those days craft, or these days also craft, is most important. How do you narrate that 2 minute story becomes a bronze or a gold? So then I told him, but I think like all of us have ego. His boss also had ego. He said, no, we are not going to change everything. So he never told him that it's coming from me. So, yeah. But he obviously changed few of those things. And then he said, no, a few things we won't change. But big story short, obviously it went and picked up a silver and few bronzes. I mean, not because of me, I think because the idea was really, really fabulous. I just tried to clean it up. So the whole idea is, if you are not capable, because we all have limited strength and vision and knowledge, if we are not able to do it, I think the world is quite small. We should try and reach out to our friends, our colleagues, our networks, and make sure that the idea gets maximized in that 2 minute. Very, 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 very important, because we make sure that we slog and make sure that campaign's out in a most beautiful way. But unfortunately, this 2 minute is everything.
Yeah.
So if we cannot crack this 2 minute, then the chance is gone. You will never be able to enter that piece of work.
No, absolutely. It, just to add, it's in a way, if you look at it, it's like advertising for the advertising. And so much so that if I recall right, the show in Busan, Korea, AdStars, they actually have a category for case videos now, which I also judge creatively. So, I mean, that shows us the reality. It is advertising for advertising.
That's interesting.
I think in FEs, you have best presentation.
Okay.
So I think Josie, you know what? I think the best person sometimes is actually your planners. You know what I mean? Show it to your planners.
Yeah.
Because what happened is, a creative, we fall in love with our ideas so much that we forget sometimes what you are doing. The planners pull back and says, like when I work with Dheeraj and everything, Dheeraj, like they, after doing it multiple times, even sending it to the global guys also, then pull back and says, Dheeraj, kaam kar raha hai kya? Dheeraj, nahi, isko ye karte karte. Fir, we then do it and show it to your partner. Because they are, see, you have to see, there has to be logic also.
Yeah,
magic, you need a logic also. And that, I think, so sometimes your planners, friends can give you amazingly well. Including, like a lot of time I have sent to people here in this group. They says, dude, I have fallen in love. Does it work? But you know what I mean? Does a case study work? You know, we have done it ourselves. But yeah, it's...
So, and the beautiful part, Rajneepak, is, I mean, I'm sure all of you have experienced this. There are now several ideas because of the multinational nature of many of our brands. Many of the, your agency's foreign offices work is India relevant or Asia relevant. They do the same thing. They send their work out to us to just get a reality check whether they are being authentic. So I think it's all evening out now.
Correct.
What's the ideal time a team should give to creating their case studies one by one? Whoever wants to take it first. What's the ideal time? What's the ideal duration? Ki itna to aapko lagana padega tabhi you can come up with a good case study. Santosh, why don't you start?
Yeah. See, sometimes I think it just falls seamlessly. What is the problem? You need to set up the problem, followed by what's the strategy or the insight, followed by the idea, and followed by the result. And the minute they fall into such a way that it all forms, all four put together forms a beautiful story. At times that doesn't happen. At times that doesn't happen. As Yuzi said, you have to keep trying, keep altering, keep looking at it, maybe flatten the structure, restart everything. And at times, I think you should let it go. If things are not falling in place, I would like to again give example when we did Pepsi World Cup, the Cricket World Cup, changed the game, followed by Airtel, Har Friend Zaruri Hota Hai. We never entered those pieces because we said maybe 80-90% of the janta won't understand what cricket means to us.
Yeah,
it's a sport that is embedded in us. It's a religion that we live. So if we are not able to tell that story to a foreigner, and if he doesn't get that kind of goosebumps, then you might as well don't enter. So we never entered that piece of work. After trying many things, we felt, no, yeah, it's not coming out the way those international guys will see it. And maybe there'll be one guy who'll try and passionately explain what cricket means to Indians. But there are 14 other juries. They will not get it. Americans will not get it. There are 3, 4, 5 nations who play this sport. And if their representatives are not there in that room, then it's a waste. So after a point, we stop both the cases. So you need to take a gut feel saying, is it working, not working? If it's not working, move on. Move on. I'm saying you can't be just forever behind that piece. And if it doesn't win, then you feel the pain a lot more.
Yeah. Josie?
Yeah, I mean, the question is an important one, but it's like asking that famous question, what is the length of a string? You know, what is the length of a string? I don't know. You know, it is whatever you want it to be. So yeah. So it is that. It all depends. It's a case-by-case thing. Some things, like Paddy said, falls into place immediately, and some take time, and some you struggle and you go on and on. And it just doesn't seem to fit. I know Raj and I tried to put together a big campaign we did for Gillette in 2012. It just wasn't clicking because there was so much we had done. It was so intricate to India. There's so many layers. And like Paddy said, after a point, you just let go. So it's that. So what is the length of a string? What's the length of the time you take for a case study? It's really depending on the case.
Kainaz?
Yeah, I think very well said by both Paddy and Josie. My answer wouldn't be very different from that. It's like, how long will you take to come up with an idea? You don't know. Now, it could come to you right now. It could come to you 3 weeks later.
Yeah.
So you don't know how long. But I think a sensible, pragmatic thing would be to do is to have some time for revisions.
Mm-hmm.
Because I genuinely feel that earlier we discussed bouncing it off people, taking opinions, one must never be too, overconfident about it. I think those things really help. So while I don't know what time it is, but I mean, in our heads, we always go with the fact that we might need 2 or 3 alterations before we reach a case study that we are happy to enter. Whether it finally wins or not is never up to you. It's about those 14, 15 people in a room. But I think it is pragmatic to have at least 2-3 alterations accounted for before you do it. And also, I think it's important to be choiceful, what these guys said, that if you can really in your gut feel that this really feels like it is a winner, then put everything into it.
Yeah.
You know, compose music for it, do whatever you need to do for it. But don't don't keep betting on horses that, may or may not.
Interesting. Related to this point that you sometimes need to give up because you understand that this is something you can't take up to a jury or something. One of the audience members has asked, his name is Govind Pillai, are awards a true recognition of a great art person? That you do you really need those awards?
It's a recognition of work, huh? It's before anything else, it's a recognition of work. And whether we like it or not, competition exists in every field. You know, it's not something that is unique to advertising. Again, like I said, it is not something that advertising invented competition. Just before this, the Cannes Film Festival will happen. And after that, there'll be another festival that takes place.
Dentist Festival.
Yes. There'll be people who win and there'll be films who don't win. Now, for example, if a great piece of film that you really believe in, does not win, that doesn't mean it's not a great piece. But if a great piece wins, it's so much better for that piece. So I think that and also I feel that one thing that it does, it pushes you to think. And I think that is really, really important, because overall, because somebody did share the load, it pushed us into thinking that, oh, this is a way you can think. Because somebody did dumb beauty sketches, you realize that, oh my God, this is also a way to do advertising. It's not just about doing a film or doing a print ad. So I think it pushes the bar ahead. So to that extent, it's important to the craft. And if you do well with awards, it is likely that your career will do well. I know a lot of people who haven't won awards, but I respect them as very solid people nonetheless.
Anyone else would like to add?
Yeah, I think I will add to what Kenna says. This is there's two things. Either you're a farmer or and you are a Formula One racer. Both the places you are fighting actually. There is a deadline. You know what I mean? Yeah, I was watching the Formula One, and I just love Formula One, not because of anything, because you have to win constantly.
Yeah.
You have to be in the top 10 constantly, and you have to have a better timing. And when you're better timing, you're actually fighting every single day to make it better and better and better. Like when I'm talking to you, my mind is actually, I'm kicking myself because I just saw the H&M design piece that got a Grand Prix.
Yeah.
I think it's a brilliant piece of work. And I'm thinking, oh my God, why I didn't think of it? Okay, that can be done also. You know what? That is possible. Can't see that time as a kid in a candy shop. You see the best piece of work done from a different part of the world, and you come back and says, "Main kya kar raha hun yaar?" Okay, and it's actually like a boost to come back. There are days I remember, like there are days like with Josie, I have done that when I was in BBDO. For days, we will sit and we'll eat Thai food with my team, with Projo, Sachin, Spikey, eating sometime in the Thai place, and says, "Yaar, kya kaam tha yaar? Kya kaam tha, dude? We have been shit. I think we have to get better. I think that has to be done." And it's the same way. In the same way, when some great piece of work has come from Kainaz or from Rahul Matthew or from Sukesh, I'm calling them, told them, dude, you know what? Thank you for kicking my ass. You know, because I feel it just wakes you up, and Kainaz is that. It's not about the winning of award. It's a seeing the best piece of work. Yeah. Someone told you a very brilliant thing. One of my old boss told me, he says, Raj, it's about what you're winning. What you're winning for is important.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that is Kainaz is about. You know, when you see a great piece of work, you actually think of 10 years from now, we are still talking about a couple of pieces of work, because you are proud of those pieces of work. You may not have done that, but it come from India, but done by someone else, says, dude, I'm happy for that kind of work. And it kicks me to do the next big piece of work.
Yeah.
So award is important.
Exactly.
Just to add, art is nothing without exhibition, right? I mean, you can't make a beautiful painting and keep it in your house and lock it up in the shelf, then nothing happens to it. And creativity actually thrives on recognition. Mm. So these are two things that, sort of drive you forward. If you're in this industry of ideas, you've got to keep upping the benchmark. You've got to keep doing something which is better than what you did last year. And so in that sense, the awards and Cannes Lions help you sort of believe in those benchmarks and want to beat them next year. So you need
that. There's one more question, and I think Senthili would be the best person to answer this. How should young creatives, writers, and art directors see, approach, and work towards awards? How can they do it, or how did you all do in initial stages of your career?
The awards are always secondary. I think that's what young people should. I mean, while you need the exhibition part, the art is very, very important, right? So you've got to crack the idea first. You've got to do something which is true to the purpose of that brand or the brief or the marketing challenge, and you solve a real problem, right? The first stage is about cracking that big idea that no one has ever done before, and that blows everybody's mind, not just the consumer's mind, but hopefully the jury's mind going forward. If that is the process, then you take that big leap, and you always tend to succeed, because you have to start by saying that I have to crack a fantastic idea or make a fabulous film which nobody has seen, which has never been done before. Then you'll reach a point where you say, okay, this is good enough to enter for awards. And that's like the icing on the cake.
Yeah, just building on that, I saw this beautiful quote when I was in college. It said, you can't play tennis with your eyes on the scoreboard. And I found that so beautiful, because it just told you about focus. It told you why you're doing something. And it's about the game first. And you see it with most people who are sort of doing well with work, right? They're enjoying the game. They're enjoying what they're doing. That comes first. If you don't enjoy it, you won't last. You'll never find new things because it's that which drives you, right? I mean, everything else is just a sort of spotlight that comes and goes. But the light inside you is more powerful.
I'll just add a bit. I think people shouldn't be coming to this industry just because it's a creative industry.
Yeah.
If you are passionate about writing, art direction, cinematography, filmmaking, whatever it is, I think if you have a passion for that particular thing, then you will be not working for your entire life. Mm-hmm. You will be enjoying, as Josie said. So just because Josie is a great writer, I don't want to get into writing. If I am good in cricket, I should get into cricket.
Exactly.
If I'm good in running, I should run marathons. So I think be clear in terms of just because somebody else is doing something else, which is wonderful, I shouldn't be doing it. Try and stand in front of the mirror and watch yourself. What you're good at, get into that and become great. And people who are in this industry, I think we are a very subjective. Creativity is very subjective. So it's 2 + 2 is never 4. It's always keeps on changing. So I always feel that we should be experimenting and doing different stuff. That doesn't matter. Even if we fail, that doesn't matter. I think you should do different things and fail rather than do cliche things and fail. So creativity is all about being experimental. And I think somewhere that experiment quotient has reduced in our industry. So, and kids, youngsters are the one who should be coming and doing fearless things. That's what will keep us awake. That's what will keep us moving. Saying, boss, I used to do this. Look at this kid. It should challenge me and reduce my age. And that is what is expected from these kids. So if you are coming, come with a lot of passion and do experimental, wild, bizarre, unwanted things. Only by doing unwanted things, it will make us realize there is something different in this kid.
Yeah.
If I may add, the day job is not winning awards. The day job is persuasion. And the day job is, doing the best for your client, for the product, and in the most persuasive way you can. What CANS tells us and reminds us regularly that we don't have to, because clients are not necessarily very brave people. They are very happy in safety, in cliches, do something which is creatively original and has worked before is the kind of space they'd like to operate in. So what awards do, you can do that to your clients too, is you tell them that, these are the boys from our industry, from India, who are pushing the envelope. This is what India, and I'm not just saying people in the US or somewhere else, these are Indian creatives, the Indian clients who are pushing the envelope. And why can't we do something brave? The fact that when Raj wins a Cannes, when Kainal wins a Cannes, what happens is clients also look at the work and they see, oh my God, these are brave. And bravery is as infectious as cowardice. You see great work and you also want to say chalo hum bhi karte hain kuch. And you must keep on trying and you must be inspired by great work and say, how is this so fresh? How is this tone so refreshing? Why is it this so original and so striking? And it's a great place. And you can't write a book to win a Pulitzer. You can't, think of it. You can't be a filmmaker and, write a film to win the Oscars. You have to, but you must aim for the stars. And if you do that, at least you will end up on treetops. If you don't reach the stars also, which is a better place than the ground. Awards inspire us. Awards tell us where to go. They're very, very important things. And they have always inspired me. Cannes has always been a source of great inspiration for me. I'm very proud when an Indian agency or a creative person wins it, because he's pushing the bar and, he's making things easier for me with my client. My client is a little more courageous to buy, the next piece of brave work, because I can say, hey, Raj can do that. You can't not let me do that. So then we help each other when we win.
Yeah. It's more about motivation, what I have understood, that, you know, just picking mistakes in your own work, but just better get motivated and improve the next time. We are running short on time, and we have one more audience question that I would like all of you to answer. At what point does it strike that a certain idea is award or Cannes Lion worthy? When it's in the creative journey, or it's when the awards are announced, or when do you feel that this is the case that we should set? Starting with Senthil.
I think you'll know immediately. I mean, there is no question in your mind if you really believed in that idea, and if it's not just you or or me doing it, it's somebody from the team. Because in this industry, as you grow, you also build your recognition ability, right? You are able to recognize, and the Cannes Lions also is like Ramanuj sir said, it is inspiring, but at the same time, it is showing you the way. It is a guiding light. So when you're inspired and you're looking at inspirational work, and then somewhere it sort of sits all in your head, and then you're able to recognize good ideas better. But you'll have to sort of say that, okay, this one is good enough for just for the Indian audience, or this one is great for Cannes. Somewhere you'll have to, you know, be able to separate them. And that comes with a little bit of learning and time. But otherwise, it's just, you'll know when you have a big idea. I mean, greatness is impossible to hide.
Anas?
Yeah, so I am a huge believer in instinct. So, I mean, I usually feel it in my gut that this feels like a winner. And you have to feel it a couple, like, for example, you're first, like he said, at the recognition stage. Then it gets created, right? There is a journey there. Sometimes you miss the plot there. And it happens. Sometimes you have a great idea, but once it's created, it feels ordinary. You know, then you have to let it go. But if at the idea stage, it feels great, if at the creation stage, it feels great as well, then I think I think most people on this panel and across the world will tell you that you only know it in your gut. It's, unfortunately, it's not a science. Otherwise, you would be winning everything every year.
Harshan?
Yeah, I think everybody has their yardsticks. I agree with what other people have said. I also go back to that feeling that, again, Raj Deepakda spoke about a little while earlier. Raj said this thing, which is a true yardstick, which is, one is, there are two aspects. One is which, you know, often when Kenaz and I jam together and we come up with something and we know that this is big, it's instant and it's based on instinct. But in most of our roles on this panel, when you are judging the work of like dozens of other people, and then you have to kind of, you know, form your entries. But at the onset, only at an idea stage, if there is a voice in your gut which tells you, why didn't I think of it before, it at least caters to what you hold supreme. And to me, that is a yardstick. Having said that, in most instances, it's like a thunderbolt, it's like a lightning bolt that, you know, it hits you and you know. Sometimes, quite like love, it can be across time. I'll give a case in point, because of course there'll be exceptions to any rule. For instance, this young team with us, Harshik and Geetanjali, they really took up the cause of Reshma, Make Love Not Scars, with a genuine, genuine urge, because they felt for that cause. And frankly speaking, and we also knew, we had zero budgets for it. Everything was done on goodwill, because the client was very serious about it, but they didn't have the budgets. We went and gathered partners. It was done on literally like a zero budget, with favors, with stumbling, with multiple rounds of all of us sitting in on edits and trying to figure out how to get it. But about 3 months down the line, and we knew we had something which all of us were very happy and satisfied with. And frankly, as much as many skeptics might like to believe that wasn't the case, because there'll be enough people who said, "Tum log ne to awards ke liye kiya tha," or whatever. This campaign happened sometime in the late middle year. And sometime in November, because the way it started connecting with people socially, on social media, we were all happy that, hey, we have a notice campaign for the cause. Of course, as creative people, you want to push the creative bar, and hence, I mean, the idea that we had chosen was that, to use a beauty tutorial and get Reshma to do it. But somewhere, I think that some pieces gather a critical mass. Mm-hmm. And one day we had no clue that this campaign circulating for a cause within our communities. But the power of social media, and again, unpaid social media, because you never know, serendipity might take you somewhere. one day we get a call from some client, and it so happened that Piyush was in New York for a meeting. And just the prior day, the Wall Street Journal in New York picked up this campaign for some reason, and somebody wrote about it on their online edition. And then the kind of critical mass that had gathered, and that's when Kenaz, me and the team, we realized, oh shit, we have something so huge on our hands. Like, we had no clue also about how the, we hadn't even thought about how the international people will react. Then New York Times writes about it. Then some multiple people started writing about it. And suddenly it became a world phenomenon. Now that is also, I mean, we had never, and it, I think touches upon the earlier one, that if you are feeling bullish about a work, if you feel that you can solve a problem in the most different way which the world hasn't seen, go ahead and do it. Uske baad mein, if the world has to notice it, they'll award it. And we are very happy with the awards. We don't shy away from it one bit, because we have said, I mean, literally as part of the tab, I won't name the magazines, but with an earnest endeavor, our client along with us, because there were no budgets, we went to practically all the leading magazines to try and ask them to give Reshma cover space. But she was an unknown. The campaign was in its infancy. Nothing happened. Next we know, Cannes has happened. Newsweek Middle East puts her on the cover. Completely without any payments. I mean, that is the power of Cannes. That is the power of an idea. And today that cause has benefited so much from all the Cannes wins that I just think it's a great thing.
Josie?
What was the question?
When do you know?
When do you know? Yeah. I think for me, it's, you know what, I have a bit of a tremor. Yeah. So when something like gets into me now, I go ballistic. My tremor goes wild. It's like a water diviner when he's going with his fork, right? And it's at the seed level. It's not at the execution level. It's at that point where you hit that idea. And I remember on Share the Load, when we put that thought down of, is laundry only a woman's job? It's as simple as when we wrote that, I just went crazy. Like, you knew you had touched not an idea, you touched something like a nerve. And when you touch that nerve, your nerve starts going wild. And I still feel it. And I remember going around telling people, and no one is reacting. No one gives a shit about it. You know, and you have to keep doing it and keep building it and believing it. And slowly it starts, you know, people are with you and there are partners and beautiful people in the agency who build it, and something happens, right? So I think the seed is a beautiful place. And for me, the seed is all that I want, man. My seed, that seed is the award, you know, when you get that seed, you know. I don't know if I made any sense.
You made all the sense to me, at least. I don't know about others.
I think Mansi, like, for me, there's two things, the simple, very drastic. One is epic brand, epic work.
Yeah.
You know, epic brand is very important because it's hard to win for epic brands. Yeah. You know, it's really tough when you're the big brands doing something, because then you are, like someone said, right? If someone does something, it helps me push my clients. How Samar Raman was saying, right? It helps me push my client. I know my next big campaign will come from the next big brand and the next big brand. So that is very important. For me, it's you're working towards to make that big piece of work for the big piece of client that you have.
Yeah.
But three things comes here. I think so just peep out those words when I say the F word, okay? One is, oh, F, you know, oh, F, how did happen? The second is, what the P? Okay, third is, how the P? Okay, so let me why. What is OP? That means keep such a simple idea, man. Why didn't I think of it?
Yeah.
OP, that happens. A lot of happens. So yeah, it's yehi to tha. Jaise ki how Paddy said that. Other font size small. OP, ye to yehi tha. Mera dimag mein nahi aaya yaar. It is so simple. Then comes what the P? What the P? That means how the hell he thought of it? How the hell he thought of it? What goes into his head, man? This is this psycho guy or something is mad about it. You know, it's some ideas that makes you really get fallen. It says, this is the reason I'm in advertising for. Then comes the third one. It says, how the pee? That means someone has crafted to the work to the last bit. You know that art directors and copywriters has gone blind. The hands have fallen down. The fingernail has gone down because he's writing 20. Sorry. I have a story about Paddy and Santo, what do you call it? Paddy and Russell, about ki wo last mein mera comma nahi aa raha hai udhar. Can you write something to last mein wo, write Paddy? that on the Laksa campaign, Laksa campaign. And the story is that they didn't come right place. So the art director and copywriter has gone blind doing that piece of write. See, craft, again, we miss sometimes. The craft is something very important. You can have a brilliant idea. You can have a brilliant execution, but when you're crafting it right, it's everything. I think that's the those three P happens. You know, you have a winner in your hand.
Santosh?
Raj, tu kya pee raha hai? Mujhe bhi wahi peena hai.
Not pee.
Kya pee raha hai?
Sanitizer.
Okay, so I'll have a slightly different perspective. I think people, some of the guys who are here have judged many award shows, so it becomes easy for them to pick the work when some of their juniors share with them. But for most others, I would like to just have a different perspective, because we, when we enter Cannes, I think we are very optimistic.
Yeah,
absolutely. I think we single-handedly made Cannes the most richest in last two decades, because we send 1,000+ entries and less than 2% gets converted. That means somewhere our judgment is not right as a nation.
Right. Yeah.
So we should come together, share with each other, share with whoever, whatever it takes, because there is a great amount of money being spent from the agency. So you better be very careful, conscious about it. So somewhere I think that thing is not right, because it goes back to the legacy. I think most of us have been absorbing work as a kid, right? From Black Book to One Shows to DNAD, when there was physical work. So when you have seen many campaigns, you know that in this category, 286 pieces have already been done. So this is not the right idea. Or this is overlapping 20%, 30%, 40%. So let's not do it. Whereas if you have not kept a track of what's been happening in advertising, then you will latch on to a basic idea, the whitest, brightest, simplest, toughest, and go, which is absolutely wrong these days to do that. And even for us, I think we are very particular about this particular will be winning in a particular category, in subcategory, in subcategory. Like, for example, I'll give example of the Nike when they converted the church into a basketball court.
Yeah.
It won a Grand Prix in design, environmental design, because that never won anywhere else. But somebody thought this is the right category. Hence, let me just put the case study correctly. And when that same piece goes in direct, I think the case study has to be very different. They can't be just doing that environmental case and enter. So we just don't take enough pain to cut the case study according to the category.
Mm-hmm.
And if you do that, then the chances of it getting higher metal increases. So I think these are some of the things that that we have been keeping in mind as a smaller group. I think the larger group needs to be more sensitive about all these things, because it will just help all of us as a country to take the metal tally far higher.
Ramanuj?
Yeah, sorry, I dropped out for a bit. There's electrical failure, power cuts here.
It's okay. Did you hear the question? We are talking about when do you know that it's the idea that could win an award?
I agree with a lot of my colleagues that it's instinctive. It's in the gut, and you know when you have a big one. Because I mean, if you're serious about advertising, you have been following awards all your life, and you know that this is a game changer, and you have hit on something which is wonderful. And you know it at that instant, but knowing that idea and, you know, and guarding it till it's executed properly and, you know, with all the love and care that it deserves is a long, long journey. You have to protect it from, you know, from yourself at times, and ensure that the craft is perfect and, you know, the case study is just right, and everything has to be done with a bit of detachment, you know, like Spartan detachment towards the end. The love is there, but at the same time, you know, the rigor must definitely be put so that it shines.
Great, great. I guess I've asked you all, pardon me if I missed someone. Thank you so much for your time today. We have slightly overshot what we had been given. But thank you so much for your time. All the best to all of those who have sent in their works and are shortlisted. Hoping to get in touch with you soon to take your quotes on your winning entries this year. Have a nice evening. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Josie, Ramanuj, take care, bye everyone, all the best.
And stay safe.
All the best, everyone.
Bye, Mansi.
Bye, bye, bye. Take care, everyone.